the two of them started walking away, and then I had realized it was a two-handed man.
I'm driving in the car, and the road would actually start to crumble, and the car would fall into a lake.
And inside this tank, there was like an alligator, a panda bear, and a shark.
Sometimes he's on train tracks, and there's a train coming, and his little paw is stuck.
It's not only amazing that they're catching the fish, but I accepted immediately that, hey, there's fish in my lawn, or there's fish, it rains, and there's a fish in the puddle.
I'm Sandy. I'm 45 years old. I'm a retired New York City police officer, and I am a mother of two children.
So, Sandy, why don't you tell us about your dreams?
Okay, well, first of all, it's always in a big house. It's either a mansion or it's a castle, but it's always one or the other. It always has two floors. There's always 10 rooms or more. It's very majestic, you know? There's like pillars everywhere. It's my house. And I should be thrilled, but I'm always very sad. It almost never has furniture, and if it does, it has very little furniture. Mm-hmm. And it's always in the back of the house, like almost like storage. I think what's most disturbing is that it's always so sad there, you know? And I don't like being there.
You're not maximizing your potential. In a nutshell, that's what the dream is all about. That's why it's sad.
Really?
Sad within. And our house represents our state of consciousness. In all the rooms, 10 rooms, many different rooms, because as we expand and explore, we can tap into different areas. And so you've got the house, but you stay in the one room. And you haven't moved in yet, see? You're not quite comfortable taking charge, taking control of all that you can become.
The good news with that dream is that when we dream of being in a mansion, that is your potential. In other words, that's really who you are inwardly, that you haven't stepped into outwardly in your life yet.
You gotta move the furniture.
Yeah, you gotta move it in.
That dream is really, it's wonderful. I know it may feel sad.
It does feel sad.
Right.
And you're saying that's a wonderful dream.
It is. Yeah. It is, as soon as you move in.
So you just need to go shopping in your dreams.
Tonight, we have a little homework for you. You're gonna program your dream tonight, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna move your furniture tonight.
The bizarre part is when you change your dreams, your outer life is just going to blossom. It's going to explode into everything you want it to be.
Well, thank you so much. Oh, my
God.
You lifted such a burden off my shoulders.
Oh.
I mean, really, that dream makes me, you know, think that that's like almost something that I have to look forward to. And I wasn't looking forward to that.
Oh, wow. This is wonderful. Thanks so much for,
thank you.
For coming and,
oh, my
and
goodness.
Sharing
thank
with
you.
Us.
Thank you so much, guys. Well, since meeting the dream dudes, it's really been eye-opening for me. That sadness that I felt in the house, you know, was, it was, you know, the sadness I've been feeling for myself.
Sandy, like so many people, like all of us really, probably has a little bit of a self-esteem issue.
Sandy was, she's on the verge of a breakthrough as well. She's in the middle of ending one career and possibly starting another and kind of in limbo and that type of thing. And all that requires on an individual is to make a decision and take action and move forward.
The dream dudes told me that it's time to move in some furniture. And I've wanted to go to college since I was a teenager, and I never did. And now that I can, I still, you know, had decided not to do it, you know. And why, you know, why? Because I wasn't important enough, you know, and now I am, you know, thanks to the dream dudes. You know, I realized that my mansion needed to be furnished, and that's a piece of the furniture.
If we look at the positive side, Sandy has an extreme amount of talent and potential that she needs to tap into.
Since taking action on my empty mansion dream, I haven't had that reoccurring dream anymore. I've just been doing rather than dreaming.
Hi, my name's Mary. I'm 36 years old, and I am an actress and a stand-up comic, and I'm married. Hey, Mary, how are you?
Hi, thanks for having me.
Oh, we're so delighted to have you.
I have a recurring dream that I'm just dying to find out what it means.
Oh, tell.
When it occurs, it's very disturbing, it's very real, and it involves my cat. It starts off where I am holding the cat, and I'm holding the cat tight. And I know in the back of my mind that if I let go of the cat will shoot out the door or run out the window or somehow get outside.
Right.
And then
I know
that will be the end of this cat's life. And I'm like holding on so tight, and he's squeezing, and the more he's trying to finagle and get out, the more tighter I'm holding him to the point where I think I'm actually hurting him.
Right.
And he somehow always like goes under or around, or he finds a way to get out of my arms. He shoots out a door, shoots out a window, shoots out a ceiling, whatever he's shooting out. And then he runs always into like a perilous situation. The situations are always different, but they remain the same in the fact that I know he's always going to die. Sometimes he's on train tracks and there's a train coming and his little paw is stuck and he can't get out of the railing, and then right before he gets hit, I wake up. And it's always a very disturbing feeling when I wake up because it felt very real. Sometimes I have to look around for the cat and make sure, you know, was that a dream or was that? And then that feeling lingers like all day.
Okay. You're holding on too tight. The dream's showing you that you're holding the cat, and it almost feels like you're hurting the cat at some point.
Yes.
You're hurt, and really what you're hurting is yourself because you're holding on too tight to something, and you need to loosen the grip on that. And the question you need to ask yourself, and only you know this, is, you know, what's going on in your life right now with relationship. Cats often in dreams, not always, it's individual to what a cat means to you, but in many cases, and it does to me, sometimes a cat will represent relationship. When I dream about a cat in a dream, it's telling me about my relationship. How's your relationship life?
Well, I'm married, and, you know, it's basically good, but there are times that, you know, we've hit really hard, you know, spots.
Right.
Maybe I'm trying to
hold on
to him too tight or the relationship too tight.
Whenever we hold on to something too tight,
right,
sure enough, it's going to slip away from us.
Yeah, it's really about freedom.
Yeah.
And giving our loved ones freedom and space to be all that they can be, even though sometimes it doesn't feel good.
Right.
To just let them make a mess in the kitchen because that's what they need to do, and love them for it.
Right.
Because you'd rather have them make a mess in the kitchen than never be in the kitchen. To be out of your life. I mean, and so it's those little things that drive us nuts that it's like, oh, you know, forget about it. Let them do their thing. But it's better to be in harmony than to be right. And when you're coming from a place of love, that's all there is.
Right.
What's next is re-scripting the kitty dream. All right.
We need
a happy ending here. So, tonight when you go to sleep, actually, before you go to bed, you can simply re-script the dream with an ending of your choice that makes you, and it doesn't matter what ending, as long as it feels good. Thanks for coming.
Oh, thank you for having me.
Yay.
Thank you so much.
Yay.
Thank you. The dream dudes told me to re-script the dream, reprogram it. That's what I was working on for the last week, really re-scripting the dream. And I got it to the point where I have a different ending now. And it was a totally beautiful feeling. It was totally different than the first dream where I felt like the cat just wanted to leave. He just wanted to leave and he was gonna die. In this dream, I didn't even feel like I had to scoop him up and grab him and hold on to him tight because I knew the cat was telling me in my mind, you don't have to worry, I'm here, I waited for you. I'm not going anywhere, so you don't have to worry now because I'm still here. And then I woke up, and it felt good. It felt good. So I did it. I re-scripted my dream. I didn't think I could, but I did.